Did you know that writing a complex number in polar form only takes 2 steps? By the end of this video, you'll master these steps, including the challenging part of finding the angle or argument. Welcome to Understand the Math. We've created free guided notes that you can use as you watch this video and placed a link to them in the video description below. There's space in the notes where you can fill out the answers to the examples that we're going to do because you can't just watch someone do math, you need to do it too. Before we dive into our 3 examples of writing a number in polar form, we'll quickly go over some complex number terminology and explain the 2 steps required for writing a number in polar form. A complex number is in standard or rectangular form when written as z is equal to a plus bi. A is the real part of z, b is the imaginary part of z, and let's remind ourselves that I squared is negative 1 and I is the square root of minus 1. The complex plane is used to visualize the set of complex numbers. Z is our complex number. A is the real part of Z and lies on the real axis. And B is the imaginary part of Z and it lies on the imaginary axis. The modulus or absolute value of a complex number is the distance from the number to the origin. We'll write this distance in the complex plane, and it's equal to the square root of a squared plus b squared. Let's now go over the 2 steps we need to complete to write a complex number in polar or trigonometric form. Up above, our number was written in standard form. The standard form of a complex number is written in terms of its real and imaginary parts. The polar form of a complex number is written in terms of the magnitude and angle of the number in the complex plane. The magnitude is called the modulus, and the angle is called the argument. Our number in complex form will be written in terms of the modulus of z, which is equal to r, and the argument of z, which is equal to theta. R is the distance from the origin to the complex number, and theta is the angle formed between the positive real axis and the line from the origin to the complex number. To find the polar form of a complex number, we begin with the number in standard form. From our picture above, we can see that A is equal to R cosine theta and B is equal to R sine theta. This gives us C is equal to R cosine theta plus R sine theta times I. Both of those terms have an R common to them, so we can pull that out and we can write our polar form as Z is equal to R times cosine theta plus I sine theta. You may recognize this part of the formula as being equal to e to the I theta. R is the square root of a squared plus b squared, and theta is the inverse tangent of b divided by a. Let's now go over the 2 steps we need to complete to write a complex number in polar form. The first step is to find r. The second step is to find theta. If our complex number is in quadrant 1, then we can find theta from the formula that we wrote above. Theta is the inverse tan of b over a. If our complex number is in quadrants 2, 3, or 4, we have 2 steps to do. The first step is we're going to find the reference angle, and that's equal to the inverse tan of the absolute value of b over a. And then the second step is we're going to find theta from our chart below. In all 3 problems, we'll write the complex number in polar form. We'll begin by writing our formula. Z is equal to R times cosine theta plus I sine theta. R is equal to the square root of a squared plus b squared. And this is going to be the square root of 1 plus 1, which is root 2. We notice that our number is in the first quadrant. So that tells us that theta is going to be the inverse tan of b divided by a. So this is the inverse tan of 1. And we know that that's equal to pi over 4. This gives us z is equal to r, which is root 2, times cosine pi over 4 plus I sine pi over 4. Let's now do our second example. Again, we'll begin by writing down our formula. Z is equal to r cosine theta plus I sine theta. R is the square root of a squared plus b squared. So this is going to be the square root of negative 2 squared plus 2 squared. And that is equal to the square root of 8, which simplifies to 2 root 2. We notice that our complex number is in the second quadrant. So theta is going to be pi minus theta sub r. Our theta sub r is inverse tan, and we have to be careful here, it's the absolute value of b divided by a. This is inverse tan of the absolute value of minus 2 over 2. So this is inverse tan of 1, which is again pi over 4. Our theta is then pi minus pi over 4, which is 3 pi over 4. So we can write our number as r, which is 2 root 2 cosine 3 pi over 4 plus I sine 3 pi over 4. And we can see that our angle is indeed 3 pi over 4. Let's now do our last example. Z is equal to r times cosine theta plus I sine theta. I always tell students if you write the formula every time you do a problem, you'll memorize it automatically. R is our square root, a squared plus b squared. We have the square root of 4 times 3 plus 2 squared, which is 4. So this is the square root of 16, which is 4. Our number is located in the third quadrant. So just like problem 2, we first have to compute our reference angle. So theta sub r is inverse tan of absolute b divided by a. So this is inverse tan of minus 2 divided by minus 2 root 3. This gives us inverse tan of 1 over root 3. Most people don't have this value memorized, so let's think about this in terms of tangent theta sub r. We have tangent theta sub r is 1 divided by root 3. We know that tangent is sine theta sub r divided by cosine theta sub r. So we can think of this as 1 half divided by root 3 over 2. And when we do that, we can easily see that theta sub r is pi over 6. Because our number is in the third quadrant, our theta is going to be pi plus theta sub r. So this is pi plus pi over 6, which gives us 7 pi over 6. So our number can be written as r, which is 4, times cosine 7 pi over 6 plus I sine 7 pi over 6. And we can see that this angle is 7 pi over 6. And our radius is equal to 4. In the next video, I'll go over how to find powers of complex numbers. If this video has been helpful to you, please consider subscribing to my channel. Keep believing in yourself and have a great rest of your day.